So before moving on to pointers, we have to understand the concept of memory when we are using a C++ program. So what kinds of memory are there that the program is being using? There are three parts of the memory that the program is using. There is a stack, there is a heap, and there is a global memory area. So what is all, how is it divided? What is there in stack? What is in heap? And what is there in the global area? You have to understand that before we move on to the pointers. So what stack is having is, whenever you create a local variable, whenever you create local variables, they are all created in stacks. Stack is the area of the memory that gets filled up bottom to top. मतलब सबसे पहले जैसे यू आर कीपिंग बुक्स इन अ स्टैक, यू कीप वन ओवर द अदर ओवर द अदर ओवर द अदर. दिस इज अ स्टैक. सो दिस इज अ स्टैक ऑफ मार्कर्स राइट नाउ इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. सो यू स्टार्ट फिलिंग फ्रॉम द बॉटम. यू पुट वन मार्कर एट द बॉटम, देन यू पुट अनदर ऑन द टॉप ऑफ इट, देन यू पुट अनदर ऑन द टॉप ऑफ इट. एंड व्हेन यू वांट अ मार्कर, सपोजिटली आई वांट द ऑरेंज वन हेयर, I will not just take it out and let the others fall. No, that is not what you do in a stack. You remove from the top. You remove from the top till you reach what you want. Understanding? So stack only means that you are filling the stack from the bottom. The area of the memory may aise create hota hai ki jo variables pehle create honge, they will be at the bottom. They will start creating the memory area. Finally, variables, when do they finish? They will be finishing from the when the memory gets freed, it will be getting freed from the top to the bottom manner. So that area of memory is called a stack. Recursive function calls, kahan se call hua, kahan pe jana hai, that is also stored in stacks only. So that part of the memory is stack. There is a separate part of the memory called as heap. This part of the memory is used for dynamic memory allocation. So whenever you want some memory at runtime, ये memory बचा के रखी गई होती है, so that at runtime when you want some temporary variable or some variable that are using dynamic memory, then heap area में से वो memory निकाल के आपको allocate करी जाती है. Now your entire program code, आपका program code भी तो कहीं store होगा, so your program code, that means main function जितने भी है ना, all definitions, all are stored and global variables, all these are stored in the global memory area. So these are three basic portions of memory that a C++ program will be using. So we have stacks, heaps, and the global memory area. So what we will be using and what we run out here, we have to understand ki concept kya. Stacks are the fastest. Stacks जो हैं वो fastest हैं, but again they are most expensive. इसीलिए जो stack memory होती है वो बहुत छोटी होती है. Heap is global memory is technically the cheapest and the mostly available, but it is slowest. Heap is faster than global memory, but it is again expensive also, and it is certainly slower than stack. तो अगर आपको छोटी और क्विक मेमोरी चाहिए, यू विल बी यूजिंग स्टैक. इफ यू वांट मोर स्पेस एंड यू कैन कॉम्प्रोमाइज ऑन द स्पीड, यू विल बी यूजिंग हीप्स, दैट इज डायनामिक मेमोरी व्हिच विल बी एलोकेटेड एट द रन टाइम. एंड योर ग्लोबल फंक्शन प्रोग्राम वेरिएबल्स, दे आर स्टोर्ड इन ग्लोबल एरिया. नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस इज वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, ये सब समझाने का द पर्पस इज, व्हाट हैपेंस इज व्हेन यू क्रिएट अ प्रोग्राम, सम पर्टिकुलर एरिया ऑफ मेमोरी, योर रैंडम एक्सेस मेमोरी, सब कुछ रैम में, प्राइमरी मेमोरी में ही सब कुछ रन हो रहा है. सो सम एरिया ऑफ रैम इज एलोकेटेड टू योर प्रोग्राम व्हिच इज डिवाइडेड इन दीज थ्री पार्ट्स. सो दिस इज योर ग्लोबल मेमोरी एरिया, दिस इज योर हीप एरिया, एंड योर स्टैक एरिया. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज व्हेन स्टैक एरिया गेट्स फिल्ड, तो वो दूसरे मेमोरी के एरिया में आना शुरू कर देगा. इट विल स्टार्ट एंटरिंग द अदर एरिया एंड the variables which were existing in the heap area will get overwritten. Problem ho jayegi. The earlier turbo C++ compilers, the nave compilers, they did not have any method of डिटेक्टिंग द स्टैक ओवरफ्लो एकदम अर्लियर वर्जन. सो वॉट यूज टू हैपन, वेरिएबल की ऑटोमेटिक गार्बेज वैल्यूज आना शुरू हो जाती थी, रीराइट होके, एंड नोबडी कुड नो इफ अ फंक्शन इज गेटिंग अ रिकर्सिव कॉल फॉर सो मेनी टाइम्स दैट द स्टैक मेमोरी हैज ओवरफ्लोन, इट विल स्टार्ट गेटिंग स्टोर्ड इन द अदर एरियाज ऑफ द मेमोरी एंड इट विल डेफिनेटली अफेक्ट द रेस्ट ऑफ द प्रोग्राम. अब इस ग्लोबल एरिया में कुछ पार्ट जो है वो तो रॉम है, जहां आपका प्रोग्राम एटसेट्रा लिखा हुआ है, दैट इज नॉट गेटिंग चेंज व्हेन यू आर एग्जीक्यूटिंग द प्रोग्राम. सो इट एक्ट्स एज नॉन चेंजेबल, बट व्हेन यू आर चेंजिंग द प्रोग्राम इट विल ऑब्वियसली चेंज हियर आल्सो. सो दीज आर द पार्ट्स ऑफ द प्राइमरी मेमोरी दैट आर एलोकेटेड टू अ प्रोग्राम व्हेनेवर यू आर वर्किंग ऑन इट. आर दीज पार्ट्स क्लियर?
एक्सक्यूज मी मैम.
हां बेटा.
Ma'am, they, for program code, there is a separate memory, is there? Means a separate area is allocated to program code. Stack is different and maybe program code ke liye alag hota hai.
Maine alag hi kara
hai. Achha, ma'am, jo aapne ye niche likhe, wo aapne char divide kar rakha hai.
I will again repeat what I am saying. There is an entire area of memory supposedly allocated. I am dividing the area of the memory into various parts. I am not saying that this area is continuous. No. Aisa dikh raha hai. Ho sakta hai memory mein alag alag parts mein divided ho ye area. But there is supposedly 4 MB of RAM allocated to this particular program. So this 4 MB of RAM, it is not continuous memory necessarily. This 4 MB of RAM is divided into a global area, a heap and a stack. Is it now clear? आप समझ आ रहे हैं व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से?
यस मैम.
एवरीबॉडी इज नाउ अंडरस्टैंडिंग? इट इज नॉट नेसेसरीली कि मेमोरी में एक सेल में ओवरलैप की बात हो रही है तो यहीं पे रहेंगे. नो, इट कैन बी कि मेमोरी में एक पार्ट है, दूसरा पार्ट है, तीसरा पार्ट. इट मे बी ऑन द स्कैटर्ड लोकेशन, बट एवरी ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम कैन वर्क व्हेनेवर स्टैक ओवरफ्लोज. इट इज नाउअडेज द कंपाइलर्स व्हिच वी आर यूजिंग, दे गिव यू अ स्टैक ओवरफ्लो एरर. So we can, if we are having an overflow, we do not get into another area of the memory. Earlier, this problem used to happen. Nowadays, they don't enter anything. They will simply tell you that there is a stack overflow so that you can reduce the number of calls or you can see whatever extra variables you have declared, etc. Whatever is happening, you can rectify. This is not continuous memory necessarily. That is not what I meant. But this 4 MB is divided into these three parts in primary memory. Whenever you are executing the program, whenever you are opening the program, execute jab karoge tab karoge, whenever you are even changing the code or whatever, there is some part for the code, some for the heap, some for the stack. Is this clear?
Excuse me ma'am.
Haan bachche.
Ma'am, ek bar wo overwritten wala fir se samjhana.
Overwriting wala?
Yes ma'am. Ma'am, jab matlab stack jo heap mein overwritten ka jo aapne samjhaya
tha. Earlier what used to happen is, see nowadays the technology is advancing very fast, but when I was studying, when I was in my school time 11th 12th, it did happen with me actually. So there is memory area in that case like this only. Supposedly this is say 0 to 2 MB. This is 2 MB to 1 MB and this is 2 MB to 3 MB and this is from 3 MB to your 4 MB. This is how your memory is divided. So this is your global memory area. So this is your heap area and this is your stack area. What used to happen is stack is completely filled. There are multiple indefinite recursive call ho gayi hai galti se. Kabhi na kabhi to stack fill ho gayi. You are calling recursively a function and the function is not getting stopped by any chance, or you are having loop which is calling itself again and again, infinite loop ho gaya hai. So somewhere the memory of the local variables is going to end, overflow hoga. So this memory, whatever was getting used, a ko memory yahan pe de di. Ab is heap mein there was other variables which were getting used. Till there is no variable, till this was free, there is no error. Till you reach where I was already holding some variables in the heap and they are getting overwritten due to stack's recursive calls, then the program will behave incorrectly. this part of the memory gets overwritten. Supposedly itna overwrite hone ke baad you come out of the recursive call. After coming out of the recursive call, you will be needing the variable of that heap, which will be having the wrong value. And then the program behaves in a manner in which you had not expected. Nowadays, the compilers take care of this. In case you are having lack of memory, they give you a clear stack overflow error that could be caused due to many recursive calls, due to many arrays, or due to multiple variables that are going beyond the size of your stack. Now, is it clear?
Yes.
See, why is stack faster than heap? Because the implementation of stack mein aapko memory, whatever the memory is, aapko address store karna padta hai. Every memory is having some address. Jaise aap, if you enter a society, there is a house number to every house. So to reach the particular house, you have to have the address of that memory location. In the stack, you do not require any particular address to be created. You only have something called as top of stack. Insertion is done at the top, deletion is done only from the top. There is no other option. That is why it is very quick. Aapko memory mapping nahi karni padti stack mein. It is extremely quick to handle. If the size of the stack is supposedly, just for example, this is an Almira. Almira mein books aa gayi. Ab agar Almira ke upar stack nahi hai, then the books can go beyond, till the roof. Otherwise, if there is some slab on it, then you cannot go overflow. Nowadays, compilers ne slab dal diye. Ab samajh aa gaya ye clearly? Stack is still faster than heap always, simply because memory mapping and address mapping is not required, because we always deal only with one address in a stack, which is top of stack. And everything else is stored in that particular manner only. So it is very quick. Is it now clear?